Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. If you have followed us long enough, you would know that we make videos on our ancestors, and this is another one on our ancestral cousins, the Neanderthals. You would be surprised to know that the analysis of the jawbone of a man who lived about 40,000 years ago reveals the closest direct descendant of a Neanderthal who mated with a modern human. Modern humans evolved in Africa hundreds of thousands of years ago but did not migrate into Europe until around 45,000 years ago. At that time, Neanderthals were already living in Europe, Asia, and the Middle East, where they coexisted with modern humans for thousands of years. Two studies of the genome of the earliest known humans in Europe have found evidence of interbreeding with Neanderthals. One female genome from Zlatýkůň, Czechia at 40,000 years old and three genomes from Bulgaria at 42,000 to 46,000 years old show that Neanderthal interbreeding occurred only a few generations back. The Bulgarian individuals are ancestral to modern populations in the region, showing Neanderthal admixture and continuous human presence in Eurasia. Just when and where our ancestors bred with their now extinct cousins, however, has been tricky to pin down until now. A new study published in the journal Nature has the highest percentage of Neanderthal DNA of any modern human ever studied. Svante Pabo of the Max Planck Institute for Evolutionary Anthropology in Leipzig said partly believed that they were lucky enough to hit upon an individual like this. All present-day humans who have their roots outside sub-Saharan Africa carry 1-3% Neanderthal DNA in their genomes. Until now, researchers thought it most likely that early humans coming from Africa mixed with Neanderthals in the Middle East around 50,000 to 60,000 years ago before spreading into Asia, Europe, and the rest of the world. Neanderthals then became extinct about 40,000 years ago. However, radiocarbon dating of remains from sites across Europe suggested that modern humans and Neanderthals lived alongside one another in Europe for several thousand years, suggesting that they could have interbred there as well. A modern human who lived in what is now Romania between 37,000 and 42,000 years ago had at least one Neanderthal ancestor as little as four generations back, which is to say a great-great-grandparent. Scientists have known for at least half a decade that living humans bear traces of Neanderthal blood, or more specifically Neanderthal DNA. The specimen, known as Oase 1, consists only of a male jawbone, and from the moment it was discovered in 2002, its shape suggested that it might belong to a hybrid between Homo sapiens and Neanderthals. Those claims have remained controversial though, but the new analysis lays the controversy to rest. The jawbone was found in 2002 in the Oase cave in southwestern Romania. An international team led by researchers from the Emil Racovita of Speleology in Romania subsequently came to study the site. Researchers from HMS, the Max Planck Institute for Evolutionary Anthropology in Leipzig, Germany, and the Key Laboratory of Vertebrate Evolution and Human Origins of Chinese Academy of Sciences in Beijing then analyzed DNA from the jawbone. Oxford's Dom Hyham, an expert on the Neanderthal-human transition who was not involved in this research, says that it's really stunning. Part of what stuns Hyham is the genomic artistry it took to tease useful genetic information out of the tiny DNA samples. Lead author Kwame Fu of Harvard Medical School and her team were able to extract the DNA from the jawbone. Pavel said they tried to do this in 2009 and failed. His lab has been working since then to improve their techniques with resounding success. One of the most exciting things about the Kowase individual is that he is from a population that did not contribute much or at all to Europeans today, said David Reach, HMS professor of genetics who led the study's analyses of population history. The genetic data show that he was a member of a pioneer population of modern humans who got to Europe early, mixed with the local Neanderthals, and then was displaced by later migrations. The genome they sequenced from the samples was incomplete, but it was enough for the scientists to conclude that between 6 to 9% of Oase's one's genome is Neanderthal in origin. People living today have 4% at most. That difference is more significant than it might seem, and they also assessed that they found 7 huge pieces of chromosomes that seemed to be purely of Neanderthal origin. That means pieces had to come from a relatively recent ancestor, since they hadn't yet been broken up by the reshuffling that happens in each generation as parents' chromosomes combine, he explains. The non-Neanderthal genome sequences, meanwhile, show that Oase 1 isn't related to humans living today. His genealogical line died out at some point. The analysis represents a biotechnical tour de force, but it also puts paleoanthropologists a step closer to fully answering to what Hyham calls the $64,000 question, which is what happened to wipe out the Neanderthals and when. Although the question remains unanswered, Hyham says the great breakthrough here is the ability to say this specific person had a Neanderthal great-great-grandfather. That puts a human timescale on it. If scientists can figure out when interbreeding took place in different parts of Europe and the Middle East, they'll be able to say in detail just how rapidly humans spread across these regions, how long they were in contact with Neanderthals, and maybe tell us at last why our nearest relatives vanished. Scientists also hope that DNA from other human fossils that predate the extinction of Neanderthals will help reconstruct the interactions between Neanderthals and modern humans in even more detail. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you liked the video. Before you go, please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.